been discussed publicly before, but not until now by Honolulu Mayor Kirk Caldwell.
Yeah, now in a move surprising to some, maybe many, the mayor for the first time is saying the rail project should stop at Middle Street, at least for now. Alex Herbal has been on the story all day long. She follows up on the latest developments today. Alex.
Aloha, Howard and Marissa. Yeah, Honolulu City Mayor Kirk Caldwell is asking HART board members to endorse a proposal to end the rail project at Middle Street at the bus terminal so they can finish the project with a $6.8 billion available. But the mayor wants to emphasize that doesn't mean that the rail project will never go to Ala Moana. The rail project was supposed to take riders from the west side and East Kapolei to Ala Moana Center. The plan was 21 stations on the 20-mile route, but that could change.
$6.8 billion, maybe $7 at the high end, where does it get us? I think most people agree it gets us to Middle Street.
On Thursday, Honolulu City Mayor Kirk Caldwell recommended to the HART board to end the rail project at 15 miles at the Middle Street Bus Depot, 8 stops short of the plan. That would mean no stops in downtown, Kaka'ako, or Ala Moana.
In the transportation meeting just now, that's still going on, I was presented the different options, and I don't like any of them.
Councilmember Kimberly Marcos Pine suggested eliminating other stops closer to each other instead of stopping at Middle Street.
We're making a decision without knowing how ridership would be affected. If we eliminate the rest of the line from Middle Street to Ala Moana, will that completely make no one ride the system? And would we financially be at a huge loss, bigger than we are now?
Caldwell says he met with Council Chair Ernie Martin to discuss the issue.
We agree that we must live within the revenue boundaries that we're faced with today.
Back in April, we told you that Honolulu City Council members pitched the idea to shorten the route at Middle Street to save money. But HART said that wasn't an option because Honolulu could lose $1.55 billion in federal funding for the project. Caldwell previously said that shortening the project would lead to fewer riders, which could cost taxpayers more money in the long run. On Thursday, Caldwell changed his tune and said he is committed to going farther, possibly even to UH Manoa, but wants to focus on what can be done with the money available.
But that's for another day, in my mind. It's for another day working with our partners, federal, state, county, public-private partnerships, should additional funding become available.
The Federal Transit Administration says the total cost to complete the project will range between $7.73 billion and $8 billion, with an estimated completion date of December 2024, in a letter addressed to the mayor and HART's executive director. That June 6th letter calls for the city and HART to submit a recovery plan to complete the project, mitigate the cost, and minimize delays due on August 7th. That recovery plan calls on HART to provide a baseline budget, identify a permanent risk manager, update the project management plan, and streamline its structure with clear roles and responsibilities. So HART board members have asked for an extension to that August 7th deadline. Here's what happens now. The mayor has reached out to the HART board members to ask for this recommendation for the city council. And a city spokesperson says the city council makes the next move. And we'll keep you posted on all these developments. Reporting live, I'm Alex Serval for KHON2 News.
All righty, Alex.
Thank you very much. The Honolulu City Council was busy at its own meeting today, hearing from HART itself about the rail project. Council Chairman Ernie Martin agrees that stopping at Middle Street is the most realistic option based on the available funds.
We all want it further. I want it to UH Manoa. But I think there is some immediate funding relief available, whether it be from the state legislature. The mayor has already stated that he will not raise real property taxes to pay for the system.
Well, Martin also says that more federal money is possible, but is not guaranteed and would not be coming soon.
Clearly a lot going on with the project, and we're on top of all of it. Stay with KHON2 for continuing coverage on any changes to the rail project. Also updates on air and online at KHON2.com as they happen.